What's up everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video we have Volkswagen ID.4, 77 kWh battery, and this is this year model. If you are new to the channel, then let me explain what we will cover. We try to answer what is the acceleration in the real world, how quick is the car. We will perform the rolling test and range test. In addition, we will check how noisy is the car driving 90, 100 and 110 kilometers per hour, and at the end I will tell you something about the driving experience. In Norway, ID.4 City version starts from 343,000 Norwegian crowns, goes up to 507,000 Norwegian crowns for the top trim version. This is ID.4 Max with 77 kWh battery with a range 505 km, 204 horsepower, and costs about 507,000 Norwegian crowns. As you might already know, there is no front trunk available. Even if we see there is some space available in front, this is a real wheel drive vehicle, so the motor is on the back, and we have 204 horsepower and 310 Nm of torque available. The official figures from 0 to 100 km per hour is 8.5 seconds, and top speed is 160 km per hour. The vehicle is quite large and heavy, I would say, and the mass is 2.1 tons. Estimated range for the 77 kWh battery is 517 km or 310 miles WLTP range. We are in sport mode and we'll try acceleration 0 to 100 km per hour, and we are fully charged. Let's try it. Just make sure if we are on sport mode. Yes, we are. Okay, so 3, 2, 1, go. And 100. Yeah, decent. 0 to 100, 3 to 1, go. Volkswagen ID.4 is half second faster than Peugeot e2008 and 1.7 seconds slower than BMW iX3. Okay, 60 to 110. Three, two, one, go. Now we are going to perform a range test and we'll drive on the highway 90 km per hour, in total 100 km, and then we check average and compare it to the capacity of the battery. And of course I will change to eco mode and I will set up the climate control for passenger to eco, because I don't have co-driver, as you can see. Okay, so computer is showing 388 kilometers of range. Status on the battery looks like 95%. Today we have car equipped with 255/40 R21-inch tires. So they are huge, and even with these tires, I can tell you we got pretty decent range. But you will see it later on. So we did 100 kilometers, average speed 84 kilometers per hour. It took us 1 hour 11 minutes, average energy consumption 16.5 kilowatt hours per 100 kilometers. And as you can see, we can do above 400 kilometers of real world range in our weather conditions, where today they are just excellent. We have plus 17 Celsius degrees. It's shiny, maybe it's a little bit windy, and of course in Norway we have uphills, downhills, plenty of them, so that might affect the efficiency. Nevertheless, I think that this vehicle with only one motor, rear wheel drive, has very, very decent energy consumption, and thanks to that, it will have very nice range. Charging from the home outlet takes about 30 hours. From wallbox, 7 kilowatts takes around 11 hours. From public charger, 11 kilowatts takes around 8 hours. And rapid charger, 120 kilowatts takes about 40 minutes. In terms of noise inside vehicle, I hear quite a lot tire noise. So I think the noise measurements might be related to the summer tires or special type of the tires. This car is equipped with 21-inch tires, so I think that might be a reason. And 100 kilometers per hour. And 110. When I'm driving 110, I hear the noise from the rails on the roof. But of course, it's nothing serious. It's I would say it's doable vehicle. Big thanks to Volkswagen Nordli Auto Moss for lending me this vehicle. Thanks to them, I could perform a real world test and present the results to you. To drive on the highway. Is it comfortable? Yes, it is. My overall experience so far is like this vehicle is looking like a quite medium size from outside, like very well put together, kind of friendly looking. But inside, it's so spacious, I would say, like maybe BMW X5, Toyota RAV4, or BMW iX3. I like the design of the interior. A pillars are medium size, so the visibility is very decent, and because you have this upright sitting position, it's very easy to observe everything what is happening on the road. That's the good thing, and I think that will be common thing for all SUVs. Then the seats are very comfortable. They are called ergo active. And then driving behavior, you don't feel you have a lot of power, but because of the electric motor, the vehicle is very responsive, agile, very nippy. The turning circle is very good, 10.2 meters, and this is achieved because we have rear wheel drive. Infotainment system, I have seen in the other reviews, that is hanging, lagging, but in May 2021 for this test vehicle which I got, everything is working fine. The boot also very spacious. The build quality, I cannot complain, it's very decent. You have here and there soft material, rubberized material, and some people complain about the black trim, shiny glossy black trim, but I just love it, so I think it's a matter of taste, what you like. I do understand that within a time it might get scratchy, but I think if you care about your vehicle, you shouldn't have too much problems with that one. I have almost 2 years old Tesla with black, shiny, glossy trim, and fine, it's all right. And then to the summary. This vehicle is very spacious, rapid, quick, nippy, and precise, has a lot of room, space inside and in the trunk. This vehicle is very suitable for families. I'm very happy with the range. The infotainment system, it's easy to use. There are some inconveniences, like maybe these touch buttons, they are a little bit inconvenient. So I hope you have enjoyed the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments down below if you would like to see also interior review, and please support me on Patreon, link in the description down below. And thank you for watching, and I see you in the next video.